So welcome to the Azores, and after, well, 5.5 months since we were rallying in Latvia at the end of the 2018 season, here we are, we're back on this beautiful island, the furthest west we go, and welcome to the season launch here of the FIA European Rally Championship, and we're broadcasting live around the world on Facebook. Julian is back with us for another season. Julian, welcome to the Azores. This is the start of our European adventure.
Yeah, it is. I've had 5 months. It's been great, just woken up now, got my nice comfy chair, but yeah, 15 difficult demanding stages, just under 225Ks of competitive action, and we say it every weekend we go on an ERC rally, we can't wait, and it's going to be great.
Our defending champion Alexey Okunev is back, but he's not only back, he's back in a new car, new team, new team.
Everything, so plenty to go on with, and plenty to enjoy.
The weather always changes out here in the Azores, but let's get up because this is the season launch. I know that Raf is just here, and he's our cameraman. Hi, Raf, how are you doing? I hope you had a good winter. We've got Chris as well, and the weather's coming in a bit, so Raf's leg's going a bit sore. So the weather's coming across, but let's have a look ahead to this season, Julian, and just see what lays ahead of us here on the ERC. So let's have a look at this clip, and we'll be back in a minute with the season launch. So we're in the centre of Ponta Delgada, as I said earlier, that the weather is coming across, but it's the season launch. We've got all the teams lining up behind us here. Of course, the Opel Adams that we've seen on the European Championship in the junior category for the past few seasons, real strong car as well. And there's all change with the Opels this season. This is the AAC Opel Rally team. And everyone's just having their photographs taken here, just getting the portraits done as 8 rounds lie ahead of us. Let's bring some of the drivers over to us. And we've got our new lineup for this year. Julian is here as well. So let's have a word with our new guys for this year, Julian. What do you reckon?
Yeah, well, that's it. Well, let's go.
Yes, come on.
Talked to you on Monday in the test that you've done. It's your first year in the European Rally Championship. What are you looking forward to most of all?
I'm looking forward to a great season. I know we have a really good team with good guys in the car and really good mechanics and everyone in the team. So hopefully we can do a great result this year.
It's a really pretty island. The roads are amazing, but it's really demanding as well. What have you made of the recce?
It's beautiful scenery, of course, but it's also very rough stages and very demanding. You can do a mistake even if you are going really slow, so it's going to be a challenge for sure.
That's it. Chris, you got Gregoire.
Bit of a talented guy as well. Belgian, well, running in the Belgian Championship at the moment. It's your first sort of proper outing on the ERC. You've done one rally before, but first time on the Azores. What do you make of this one?
Yeah, it's a really difficult rally. We just did the Ricky, and I think it's really demanding, really rough stages, and we don't have so much experience on the rally. It's a good result at the end of the rally.
We got the volcano stage, which is being run on Friday as the middle of the loop. Everyone talks about Sasse Sidas as just being this iconic stage, rallying around the top of that volcano with changing weather conditions. What did you make of that during the recce? What do you think of the changing surfaces on that stage?
Yeah, not easy. When you see, we were reeking actually, and it was really sunny, and going down the stage, then it just began to rain. So I think it will be really difficult with our not so big experience on gravel to feel the difference in the surface. But yeah, we will see how it goes, and we will try to take as much experience as possible.
When did you arrive on the island? Because we had the pre-event test on Monday. Today it's where are we now? It's Wednesday today, isn't it? I keep forgetting all the days blend into one to the other. When did you arrive on the island?
We arrived Monday at 8:30. We were just coming back actually from Belgium, where we drove the Spa Rally, where we took the victory in the RC4 category. So yeah, it was a short night.
And then, so you travelled through the night to get here. Were you tired before the pre-event test, or did you get some sleep on the plane coming over?
We got a bit of sleep. It was not ideal, but it was just enough to do a good Monday test. And yeah, where we took where we had the occasion to get a good feeling with the car and try to feel and try to establish a good setup for the rally.
Okay, that's good. Right, Julian is just over here. We're live, of course, on Facebook, and welcome. You can wave to all your friends back home that I presume are watching you at the moment.
Hey.
So Raf's behind the camera as well. Another driver. Are you?
We've got another set pair of cars. These drivers, you can go now. Get out the rain. You can get out. So that's great.
Thanks very much.
We've got another pair of cars here now. That is the FPAC Portugal Team ERC of Alonso Monteiro and Pedro Antunes. We've got an ERC 1 car here, which is a Skoda. The one on the far side, the white one, that is an R2 car in the junior category. So that is our Peugeot 208 R2 car. Just waiting for the drivers. There's a photo call, as Chris says, as you're just looking around. It's the launch. This is it. This is some of the selected teams coming to see us and get their photographs taken, their team portraits. Overlooking the harbour here. Chris knows a bit about it. We're watching a sailing boat, weren't we, Chris? Come on, don't hide. Don't hide. We're watching a sailing boat. He loves his sailing, right? He really does, don't you?
I do. That's it. When you come to the Azores, when we were saying looking at sailing boats, you know, the Azores is the...
My yacht's over there. You can't quite see it. It looks massive. I've got a picture of it. It's huge.
You know, the Azores, we're the furthest west that you can go in Europe, basically. And the next stop off for all these sailing boats, they all stop off here in Ponta Delgada in the Azores on the way over to the Caribbean. And because a lot of sailing boats head from Europe over to the Caribbean for the winter, and then they're all on their way back now. That basically, if you go behind where Chris is there, that way, you've got nothing until you get to the Caribbean. And if you go the other way, then we're over towards mainland Europe and Portugal, Julian. But
so where's America? Because this is halfway between the mainland and America. Then it must be that way, yeah?
No.
That where? Which way?
That way is Europe.
Really? Okay, right, yeah.
And then that way, is America, and that's it.
We are in the middle of nowhere. Just leave it like that. It's a great place, though. Right, got a photo call going on behind us. We are waiting for our drivers from the main car, our junior drivers. Normally, it's the kids who don't turn up on time, but the kids are here early. Our elder statesmen aren't here now. But some of the drivers are hanging around. We've got a queue of cars behind us waiting to come in and get their portrait photographs done and things like that. And we'll go through a few of the teams that are competing here this weekend. And bear with us. We are missing a driver or two aren't we? Should we stand in? We might get a
should
drive.
Get a photograph? Should we just creep look at these R5 cars, though. They're just incredible.
Do we look any very good? Do we look very good?
R5 cars are just amazing.
We'll interview Pedro first while we're waiting. We'll interview Pedro.
Yeah.
Yes, I know that's your car.
You'll have this one eventually, Pedro. So we're looking here, R2 and R5 alongside each other. Obviously, you're in two-wheel driving. Welcome to the ERC for this season. I mean, well, representing Portugal. What are your hopes, dreams, and aspirations for this year?
Well, we expect a difficult year, of course. There are lots of competition, really good competition. Our hopes it's to fight for wins in this and try to be in the podium or try to win, actually. That's our goal. We'll try to do it, we'll fight for it, and let's see in the end.
But being from Portugal, you've been to Portugal before. I don't just need to just pull you away for just one moment, or just while we swap the cars over. But being from Portugal, have you been to the Azores before? Yeah, obviously, have you rallied on this event before?
Yeah, we have done this rally last year and the other one before, so two times here. Last year we had a crash in the first stage, so actually we didn't enjoy the rally and didn't get any experience from it. But yeah, we will try. We know the stages. There are lots of new stages this year, but we will do our best.
Okay, that's good. Thanks very much. Good luck. Let's just cross over to Julian over there, who's with Alonso.
We've now found you. You've turned up, Alonso. How is it? Obviously, first round of the ERC in Portuguese soil. How is it for you?
For me, it's the second year on the ERC, a rally that I enjoy so much. One of the surfaces that I love. Azores is one of my favorite rally of the season. I think this year is we improve a lot the pace. So I think now we are much better than last year. Stronger, and we want to show that.
You're still going to enjoy it as much. Last year you had so much fun, smiling all the way through.
Yeah, this is the, I think the last year we was the first year to take notes and to try to learn the stages and improve the pace notes and everything. This year we want to be on the top 10 and try to also to, of course, keep enjoying. But also to try to show to our sponsors that also we can beat some guys also on the top 10.
Okay, right. We need you for your photographs. So we're going to just get out of the way. We've got the cameraman out to the side so the photographs can be taken. Whoops. I forgot I was on a cable.
That's the problem. You can get rid of the cable if you want.
It's all right. We're having the photo shoot now. Let's get the cameraman getting the photo shoot. And we've got another interview going on. We're like a person short. Look at that over there. Yeah, Skoda R5. We're going to look at right. Let's just go over here, Chris. We're going to go over here. Right. So this is our calendar. While that photo shoot is going on,
the calendar's still being put together behind.
Yeah,
me.
Daniel's fixing it. This is where we are, Azores. Here we are. This is from what, Geneva? Okay. This is the distance from Geneva, but we're in Azores. Round one. Round two. Rally Alas Canarias, just at the first weekend of May. Then we go to Liepaja. Normally that's the final round of the season. It's round three at the minute. Then on to Poland. We've moved forward. You'll need more than a screwdriver to fix my head. Poland is now round four. It moves from a September date to a June date. We've moved from an October date to a May date there. So those two are really kind of mixing it up. We go back to Rally di Roma Capitale on the tarmac, the Italian tarmac. And the 19th and 20th, I can't remember what month that was now. That was, that's July. Then, in August, we go to Barham, Czech Rallies Lynn. A red rally, really tough to manage one. Then, the end of September is Rally Cyprus. And then a new rally for us to finish our season off. Mid-November, we're going to Hungary. I haven't been to Hungary before. I can't wait. And we've got a night in Budapest afterwards.
The ERC Awards, which were held in Paris just before Christmas at the start of December, weren't they? And
I missed
that. We've got the ERC Gala at the end of the season. That's being held in Budapest this year. Great thing is with this thing, you see Daniel's just putting that back together. This has been in the office, in the corner of the office all over the winter, and it's been packed up and taken apart and brought out here in the van to the Azores.
I'm waiting for one day when there's a Skoda turns up with only three wheels. Yes. Because we've had that now for a year and a bit.
I don't know.
It's great. I love this, though. I really do like this. This is brilliant. And a lot of the drivers have their pictures taken next week. It's really cool. I don't know whether we should move it further out and then we can use it more often. But, okay, so our FPAC, what is their full name? FPAC Portugal Team ERC. They're just moving out now. Next up will be
should be coming.
We've got Rally Team Spain.
Oh, Spain.
Rally Team Spain, they've jumped the queue. Yeah. Unbelievable. Rally Team Spain.
You're in the way. Joe's trying to take a picture.
Oh, sorry, Joe. You want a picture of that?
Joe's trying to take a picture. Oh,
man.
Everyone wants a picture.
Sorry, I'm in the way. Okay, Rally Team Spain are going to turn up now. They're coming through first. They obviously want an early night, but Efren Lorena and Sara Fernandez, yes, are the crew there. They were in this car last year. I don't know where Chris is going. They were in this car last year. This is a car, amazing. When you see it come out, and out to here, they built that car themselves. Driver and co-driver from a body shell. Chris, you're a bit further into the action.
Yeah, just have a quick look over here. It's quite noisy under here at the moment. But if Raf, I know that he's going to complain that it goes from light to dark with the camera, but everyone's all lining up. And what's above us here? We're in the basically the ferry port, the ferry terminal in Ponte Delgada. So this service park is right downtown. The whole sort of city is just here. We've got all the ferries and the cruise liners all line up at the end of this building, basically. And this is where people come on and off the ferries and so on. There's the sailing club is just over here, and all the boats are tied up. We could try and wander through there in a little bit. Everyone's just hiding underneath, but just getting some cars through. This is Evren Lorena just coming through. Here he is. We'll talk to Evren in a minute, but he's just going to go and have his photograph taken. Let's just wander down with Le Grand Raf. Raphael, who is holding the camera. Hi, Raf. You can put your thumbs up in front of it if you want. We've got everyone from the Peugeot Rally Academy. We've got Katie's car just being pushed through here as we speak. That's not Katie's car. Katie's car's somewhere else. That's Russell's car, just prepped by Santa Luck. And then this one. This is the car. This is our defending or reigning ERC champion, Alexei Lukanuk. New ride for him this year. There is Alexei taking that win at the end of last season. And look at this, in the Citroen this year. So switching from the Fiesta, which you've seen Alexei in for pretty much most of his career. He's good. And bringing this car through. So we'll see how the new Santa Lock driver, Alexei Lukanuk, gets on in this new car for this season. But everyone's all lining up here. So as we say, this is the season launch. I'm just going to wander ahead while Santa Lock gets themselves all in position. Efran is here, just getting his photographs taken now. Sarah Fernandez and Efran Lorena, they're, as you can see here, we'll just climb over the tape. Hopefully Raf's not going to hurt himself too much. They actually build this car themselves, so we'll wait until they get their photographs taken, and then we'll have a word with Efren Lorena from Spain. You remember back in the Canaries last year, Julian, you know, that massive impact that he had on his home event, that crash last year, but car's looking good. It's a new one, this one. They've built it pretty much from scratch.
Yeah, they have. Well, they built this car themselves, like they built the last car. It's part of the training. They earn a bit of money for building it and things like that, but most importantly, they learn how exactly that car is put together. But yeah, that big crash they had in Canaries, they're on the podium here last year. Unlucky, they should have potentially could have won it, but they had a puncture and then a couple of other little mistakes and problems. They're just having their photo shoot. I'll get out of the way so you can see that photo shoot going on now. We're going to get a friend straight over once he has had his picture. They'll get a quick word with the Spaniard. Had an impromptu interview with him, which kind of turned out to be one of those blooper moments on Monday. A friend. We'll get someone else to drive the car. Sarah can drive it. We'll get you. He's over here. Yeah. We'll be only a minute. A friend. We're live on Facebook, ERC Facebook page. Start of another season. Looking forward to this.
Of course, we are here. First rally of the year. And we will try to do our best. We know that it's going to be difficult, but we can do it, so we'll try it.
I mean, that year's experience last year makes a big difference. You come here looking to win.
Yeah, of course. We want to try to win. This is the luck we want, but of course we know that it's going to be difficult, and yes, we'll see at the finish of the rally how we are on the overall.
Okay, that's great, brilliant. We're going to get a co-driver in. Let's get Sarah in. Yeah, come on, let's get Sarah in.
We're coming in.
Don't panic. Yeah, you're okay. Sarah, you and Efren have built this car. Looking forward to this year?
What?
Are you looking forward to the season? They want you to sit down. Look at that. We don't need to sit down. It's raining. Are we sitting down?
Our producer
is... Oh, man, we're sitting down now. This is like an impromptu.
Sit down.
Oops. You use your microphone because my cable won't reach.
We need to get Chris closer.
Need to get Chris closer. Sarah, you can have that. You're like a superstar now.
No,
But no, you're looking forward to this season. How has the recce been?
The recce, yes, the day was good. The stages are very difficult. I think it's a very difficult rally. For the co-driver, it's very important. We have to be focused on the road and too difficult.
And the rain now just starting to come through. But a friend and yourself done 1 year already in ERC, so the second year hopefully a little bit easier.
Yeah, I think a friend knows the rally and knows the Sete Cidades is a very important stage in this rally, so I think we can do good rally.
Okay, right, we'll let you go so you don't get wet. And your English is perfect. It's better than my Spanish, I tell you. Certainly better than my Spanish.
Julian, right.
Where are we going?
It's raining. And yeah? So what we'll do, I don't know, I'm putting my arm around you. We haven't won the rally yet, have we? We haven't even started.
Not yet, but we will win it. Yeah, because we're always at the finish line before anyone else. Because they've got to come to us. Are we going to go inside?
We're going to go inside, but we're going to have a quick clip. We're going to play this clip in, which is, of course, what the ERC is all about in 2019. Let's have a look at this clip, and we'll be back in a minute, out of the rain. Okay, so we're back live here on our ERC season launch live on
sofa. Well, it's not really a sofa, is it?
Upstairs in the hospitality area, we've got...
We should have brought them. We've got some these big blow-up chairs. They're really comfy.
Maybe we can run up and get some in a minute. But we're on the ERC director's chairs at the moment, as our director's telling us what we should and shouldn't be doing. And the rain's raining, so all the equipment's getting a bit... well, the rain's raining. Of course it's raining, but...
they need to go in a little bit more, I think, as well. Anyway, we'll sort that out when we're sorted. But behind us, you will see the official title for this team. They were a little bit kind of like out of sync, and it caught us unaware. Peugeot Rally Academy of Johan Rossal, which is car 30, and then the other car, car 25, is Katie Munnings. So we've seen Katie for three or four seasons before, but Rossal is new to this. It's new to our championship. Winning Peugeot Cup, so he's in here. But we're going to get a word with Johan and Katie. And we'll get a word with them. They're just having their photograph taken. It's starting to rain a little bit more. So what I'm going to do, I think the cameramen need to go further back in so that they don't get wet. I'm not bothered about getting wet.
Are you quite happy with that?
There you go. It doesn't matter to me about getting wet. I'm just concerned about kit.
Hang on, everyone's getting... Now, Chris is getting going on.
Chris has been brave. I'm going. See ya.
Chris is now...
He's now got... He obviously doesn't like me, does he, very much?
Right.
What are we doing?
I have no clue what's going on. Let's have a
we need the car in the background.
Oh, yeah.
Right. We will be a little bit more. The rain has started to come down a bit more. It wasn't meant to rain, apart from Monday. That's gone wrong.
Yes.
Anyway, right. So we've got behind us, you can see from Raf's camera, the two car team, Peugeot Rally Academy. And the left hand side is Katie Munnings and Veronica Engen. And on the right-hand side is Johan Rossal. Johan is walking towards me, So we're going to get a quick interview with him. How are we doing, Johan? You okay? You're good? We'll use your microphone, Chris.
How are you doing? Nice to see you.
So,
right. You can have a go on my mic.
Okay.
You can hold that if you want.
What?
Look at that. Wow. That's like a privilege, that is.
It's funny.
It's funny, yeah. Johan, you've got a smile on your face. It's the eve of the first round of this year's ERC Championship. How much are you looking forward to this?
Yes, it's my first time here. Good rookie. So difficult and a lot of condition and grip different. I will see tomorrow for the start.
It is a really beautiful event, but very demanding as well. What are your hopes for the whole season, though? A lot of new rallies for you.
Yes, it's a new season, new rally. And I hope a good result for the first. And we'll see the future. But I hope to win the ERC3. With Peugeot, with Saint-Eloc, and it's my target, but it's not easy with the guys from Llarena, with Opel Junior Team, Opel. So difficult, but okay. It's a good target.
A good target, that's it. That's brilliant. Casey is just doing an interview over there at the minute. We'll keep an eye on over Chris's shoulder for Katie when she comes back. I'm believing it's stopping yes. raining. Katie's on her way. Here she comes.
She is, right. Katie
She's on her way
Mullings.
Over.
Katie
We've seen
Mullings.
Katie, as we said,
Can
quite
I
a few
to
times.
Is that a,
You're going to talk to Katie. I can't believe you've talked to her. Right, I'll get Veronica
been so
then.
I'm so excited all day that we're going to talk to you at some point
Are you
today.
Hogging the drivers?
I'm not hogging the drivers. Julian's hogging the drivers. I'm hogging Katie Mullings. We're live on Facebook. This is, of course, the ERC season launch. But you're a bit of a veteran here in the Azores. You've been here a number of times before. Highs and lows here, of course, in the past.
Yeah, I'm a bit of a local. It's nice to know the stages and have the experience. I've done it fully for 1 year. And before that, I only finished, I think, 2 stages before I had an accident. So, a bit of experience. It's a bit drier this year, I think, on the majority of the stages. So it's completely different conditions, and we know how quickly it can change out here. But definitely to have some of the experience is really, really useful.
And you got some good sponsors this season as well.
Yeah, it's great to be working with Patrick more closely and also Red Bull. I'm really excited to make the most of this opportunity this year. But, you know, our goal is the same, to keep progressing and keep making improvements like we have been. For the long run, I think it's the best way.
Casey, making improvements as well this season. You've got a veteran co-driver, an extremely talented co-driver this year as well. Veronica Elgin joins you this season. Veronica, I mean, welcome to the ERC party. You've been here before as well. You know Katie. What do you make of this new combination? Are you looking forward to this one? Is it working well so far after the recce?
Yeah, I think it works very well. We had a good pre-event test also on Monday, and I think we're working very well together, so I'm just looking forward to start now.
And have you managed to give Katie some tips and tricks and other bits and pieces? Because you've been here before, haven't you?
Well, not at this rally. I haven't actually done this rally. But during the recce, I'll come with some tips and, if I feel I can help her. So, yeah.
That's good. Everything all working well in the car, Katie?
Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, as Veronica says, she's got loads of experience, and it's really great to learn from her on the recce. I can already start to see how I want to change my pace note system going forward, and it's definitely something that we're going to work on before Gran Canaria. It's just about keeping it simple. I think keeping the essential information on these roads very technical, and don't want to overcomplicate it. We'll see how we go, but I'm feeling good for this one.
And just the cars lining up behind us, you know, your car's prepared by Saint-Eloc, and you've got a new kid on the block. Well, not really a kid on the block. You've got reigning ERC champion in the camp this season, driving the Citroen. What's it like to have Alexi looking at kind of just a couple of doors down for you in the service park?
Yeah, it's insane. I mean, definitely a cool team to be part of this year. He's got quite a character as well, so it's fun to be around in the service park, and I think it raises the mood of everybody. I'm definitely expecting some drama though this year. I don't think there's ever an ERC season without Alexi and a bit of drama, so it's cool to be close to that. And of course, to learn from his experience as well. He's massively experienced on all of these rallies now. So any tips we can get from him, we'll definitely use.
Excellent. Fantastic. The two of you, the two ladies here this weekend, Veronica and Katie, good luck. I don't know where Julian is. I've got an official umbrella holder behind me.
I'm stood behind
where
you.
Where has Julian gone? He's run off. He's there.
Look,
I couldn't see him.
I'm just looking at admiring your work from behind the scenes.
What are you
that's what I'm doing.
You can go now. No, you can stay if you want, but you can go if you want. But
are you going
or staying?
Part-time, as well. My cameraman's on his way.
Also, we do have to go and do some pace notes and onboard video training.
Veronica's getting stroppy already.
Ah, no, she's not. She's on it.
We'll let you go. Julian's going to go and do something now. I don't know where you're off to.
I was just going around. I'm on a cable. I'm on a cable. Anyway, we've got the next thing. Let's move out of the way.
Do you know? We have this plan of how this is all going. This is the plan.
That was the plan.
The plan is out of the window, highlighting. It's all gone a bit out of order.
No, it hasn't. They turned up late. That was the problem. Right. Okay. We are here. We now have behind us. We're getting a bit of a double header here, but we have three cars behind us. This is, believe it or not, the Santaloc Junior team, consisting of the Peugeot here on the right-hand side. This is Sean Johnston and Alex Kihurani, the co-driver, both from America. So we're in USA. People coming in from the USA, from the ERC. I just don't know why I'm talking quietly, because they're doing photographs, not film. Then Alexei Lukanuk has just put his sunglasses on. He's our defending champion with Alexei Arnatov, the co-driver. And the furthest car away is Cinder Frosef and Jim Hippie in the co-driver's seat. That's number 33 this weekend. And now we're going to get the mechanics and all the team management into the photo. Six cars from Santaloc here this weekend. This is three of them. We've just seen two of them, which was Katie O'Nohan's. And there's another one still to come from the Swedish national team, which is going to be, I'm going to say the wrong name then, but it is Mateus Elderson. That's who that is. His car is coming in. But this is the three of the Santaloc teams. They're kind of six cars, but they're coming in three separate sections because of the separate teams that they are running. So we've got one of the new Citroens in the middle. That's the first time we've seen a C3R5 on the European Rally Championship making its debut. They were testing on Monday, both drivers, Mateus Elderson and Alexei Lukanuk. He's got his shades on. Why he needs his shades on? It's raining. He doesn't need his shades on, but he's so cool. Surprised he hasn't got his guitar with him, I tell you.
I think Alexei's amazing. He is kind of Russia's answer to Ken Block, isn't he?
He's a bit bonkers, isn't he?
He's very, very quick as well.
But what I like about it, right, is he's come in a different car, right? He's come in a new car, new team. He's got different tyres. He's on Michelin's this year rather than Pirelli's. And for me, that's great. That is really, really good. Pure and simply because it's given us something different to talk about. It's a new challenge for him. Rather than just coming back in the same car, I've been there, done that, won the championship, I'm just going to stay safe. He's taken a gamble and a risk to come in a different car.
Well, as the team are just taking the photographs behind the...
We're going to need to grab some drivers.
We're going to have a word, hopefully, with Alexei before he runs off.
You go and get Alexei before he drives off.
Alexei, and we're live on Facebook at the moment, live around the world.
We don't need him to drive the car.
We're incredibly talented, reigning ERC champion. Tomorrow when we head into the qualifying stage, you get to defend being ERC champion, but in new equipment this year. What's it like driving the Citroen?
Yeah, we had small tests. We jumped in and drove quite fast straight away, so it feels good. I was worried not to have that speed, but it seems okay. But of course, we need to wait for the first proper stages to see where we are. I'm worried, to be honest, out of real insight, but it's really exciting.
And then you had to adjust your driving style from the Fiesta. You were in the Fiesta for a few seasons, and you were quick in that. Have you had to tweak anything to get used to the situation?
Yeah, we will see through the rally. It takes time to get used to it, to build things around, find the pace and the rhythm. I hope the car would deliver a good feeling. It's the most important roads, so... I'm pretty confident and forward.
It's going to be good to watch you in this car this weekend in the Azores. Alexei, good luck and good luck to the season as well.
Yep, thank you.
Okay, thanks very much. Alexei, looking like, let's just whiz over.
Okay, I think he's...
Now, thanks very much, Alexei.
Yep, we can step further back. Right. Alexei's moving his car.
And, we're going to whiz over here.
We're just going to go across this way and then don't go too far. We don't want you running over. Right, okay. Syndra, we're here. You've just had your photo shoot done. You've been in the ERC before, but now back with a full program in a car that you're really enjoying.
Yeah, and a team that I'm really enjoying as well. I'm looking forward to get started now. The stages of AZORES is different from what I'm used to, let's say it that way. But we have done our preparations good, I think. And I'm looking forward to start the season, and let's hope we'll have a great weekend.
Last year it was so disappointing, so many kind of little things that went wrong. This year, I mean, last year if you didn't have bad luck, you didn't have any luck. But let's hope you got some bit of good luck this year.
Yeah, I certainly hope so. Last year we tried to do everything properly. We did so as well, but things out of control just kept on went wrong. I think this year I'm in a good position to fight for the championship, so that's definitely my goal. So let's kick it off this weekend with a good result.
Okay, just watch out behind you because we have the next car coming. Thanks, and we'll see you over the weekend. We're going to go to Chris, who's with the USA guys.
Alex, Chris is here. I just need to show real quick. Alex is, we've seen you before on the ERC, but you've been co-driving with Sean last season. We last saw you in Poland last year. I'm just going to jump in and just have a quick word with Sean.
Should you stand? Or are you gonna
I'm going to sit down here. Now we're all look at us right now in the middle here. Sean, so you come from a gaming background.
Yes.
And now you're doing it for real here in the Azores. So it's pretty close to home for you, isn't it? Well, coming from California.
Yeah, I was going to say the middle of the Atlantic is not quite Northern California, but yeah, no, I'm loving it. I'm grateful to be here, yeah.
On the ERC, you're kind of the closest, really, we're going to get to home for you, to the American continent.
Exactly. This is as far, I guess, if you think about it that way, this is as close as it's going to get this year.
When we saw you on the ERC in Poland last year, you said you come to have a look, and here you are. It's like dreams have really happened. It's a good season for you, well, starting off in the Azores, and a full campaign for you this year.
Yeah, full proper campaign. That's exactly it, is it? I'm very, very grateful to have the backing to put together a proper program to learn as much as I can this year. Is it, you know, I come from the sports car racing background, so I have a lot of experience in cars, but this sport of rallying is still very, very new to me. This is just my second year ever, so to do the full 8 rounds of the ERC, yeah, for me it's going to be about getting as much kilometers and experience as I possibly can, encountering all the different surfaces, the different conditions, and yeah, learning and growing and hopefully developing and getting that pace a little bit closer and closer and closer to top guys.
That's good. That's Sean Johnson here, who is a bit of a legend, and the moustache is going to be making some headlines this season.
I'm not so sure about that yet, but the moustache maybe is legendary. Yeah.
Let's just have a quick word with Alex Kihurani. That's Kihurani.
Yeah. Got it. Yeah.
Kihurani.
Back, so it's okay.
You were co-driving with Alex Papotas a few years ago, weren't you?
Yeah, so that was the last time I was here in the Azores, which was 5 years ago. And fortunately, this is actually, that was the last time we ran the dodgy bit of such a Sedatis at the beginning. So hopefully a little bit of that experience will come into play. Mm. Yeah.
So has it been difficult to tame Sean in the car and get him to understand this loose surface here?
he's been fairly well behaved, just, you know, a few roots, hoots and hollers. But other than that, no, he's doing a really good job, and he's stepping it up quite a bit every single rally. So, yeah, we'll see what we can do here.
Okay, that's good. These two guys are going to be pretty good. You'll want to watch this year. I'm not sure where Julian has gone to. We're going to have a good... Thanks, guys.
Cheers, you're welcome. Have a good one.
That's Sean Johnson, who is a legend with Alex, who's co-driving. Julian is here with our next bunch of drivers just lining up.
We've been doorstepped.
No way.
Yeah, by David. Off the job. I can't believe it. We had him lined up. I'm talking quietly because he's doing an interview. He doesn't need us talking over him. But I'm going to get Mateus Elderson next. And then I think we've got Marion Griebel lined up for you in the chair.
In the chair.
Nazi. I want a picture of us in that chair. That's really cool. Okay. With this thing in the middle. I want that. That's great. But what were the Americans doing? We've got people coming from all over the world.
Yeah. Well, Sean Johnson, we saw him in Poland, that's what I say to him. We saw him in Poland last year, and he was driving the Opel Adam last year in Poland. And he was come to look at the ERC with a view to having a campaign for the future. That's all come to fruition. And when we were in Poland, it was like August last year, wasn't it? It was real hot there. But this guy's
right. You're not going anywhere. We've got you. So I don't know which camera we're on, but we're on one of them.
I want to shake his hand.
You want to shake his hand? I'll shake his hand as well then. Hey, hello! Matthias, yes. You've just been doing another interview. It's Interview City here, but you're back in the European Rally Championship. Different car, different team. How much are you looking forward to this now in an R5 car?
I just want to start. No, I said to the earlier reporter here that 2015 was the last time I was here. And I forget how difficult this rally was and how fantastic it was. The Tronchera stage. And to be back in an R5 is it's a little bit about a dream. You know, we were here with the private team, owned Peugeot 208 4 years ago. Now we are in a professional team like Sanctiloc Racing in an R5 car in the top spec. So obviously dream can be true. And now we have to do the best we can in this situation.
I mean, what are the hopes? Because obviously youngsters in the top category, they want to win, they want to do everything. But what are the hopes realistically? What are you looking at?
You know, I'm starting to be old now, so I have to be clever. If you asked me 4 years ago, I would say go flat out. But now you have to be clever. It's a lot of championship points to be earned here in the rally. And this rally is difficult. So you stay. If you have a good feeling, you can push. But if you don't have the feeling, you have to stay on the limits. It's very easy to be here to go over the limits.
Okay, well, I'm going to let you go on because Chris has Marion Greaves with him.
Back in the hot seat with the legend that is, well, I keep calling everybody a legend, but Marion Greaves is, well, two times ERC champion in both categories, in the under-27 class in the Opals a few years ago, and they're moving up to winning the under-28s at the end of 2017. Marion, you're back now in the big boys category up in ERC1 and driving the Polo this year, so... What amazing to have you back on the championship. We missed you last year. We did see you in the Azores, but you're back again.
Yeah, I was quite thrilled that I was not competing more rallies last year, but I had a good possibility with Peugeot Germany and the German Championship, where I was clinching also the title last year. So all in all, it was a good year, also last one, but now I'm really happy to be back in European Rally Championship, and I'm looking much forward to the season.
You drove the Opel Adam, the two-wheel drive category, and then moved up into the R5s. We've been really looking forward to the car joining us on the ERC. This is the Polo, the R5 Polo, and you're driving that this weekend. But you're not starting the City Show tonight in Ponte Delgado. What's the story?
Unfortunately, we had a slight show on the test, and the spare part which we need for that is still one away with mechanics to the island and is driving too late this evening. And the other one is stuck in the car at the airport. So, unfortunately, it's not possible to drive that cool crowd this evening, but no problem at all for the weekend.
So the parts are coming out here to the island, shipping them over from Germany. The car itself, you'll be starting the rally, of course. The car itself, what's the Polo like to drive? Because we've been waiting for it to join the ERC for a few months now. What's it like? Is it taking difficulty to get used to, or is it comfy and sweet?
Generally, I feel really honored to be the first one as a German driver to drive this cool German car in the European Championship. But I have to say that I have nearly no experience with the car because I was doing just 15 kilometers testing, nothing else. So for sure it will be not easy in the first stages to adapt to the car. But I think the results in the previous event show that it is a great car with really, really good performance. So I'm quite optimistic that we can score good results.
That's good. We're going to look forward to seeing you at the end of the stages over the weekend. I want to ask you one question, Marion. This is probably a little bit of a strange one. Are you a policeman as a day job, or is that all finished now? Did you used to be a part-time policeman?
That would be cool if I'm a full pro, but no, it's like all the seasons before, so I'm part-time policeman and part-time rally driver.
That's fantastic. I'm not going to be good at driving too fast. Let's switch over to Julian. Marion, thanks very much. Let's go over to Julian, who is with Bruno Magalhães.
Yeah, I am with Bruno Magalhães. Bruno, back on Portuguese soil, the Azores Rally. Different car, though. Hopefully, well, that smile on your face tells me that you're enjoying it.
Yes, I'm enjoying a lot. It's a new challenge for me with a new team, a new car. I hope to make a good. I hope to make a good job here. As you know, I won three times this rally, so I love this event. Of course, it's the Portuguese event, so I have a lot of fans here. My family, everybody supporting us, and I hope to make a good job. Okay, I don't have so much experience with the Hyundai for the moment, but I think you can achieve a great result.
When you say great result, what is a great result? A podium or a first?
No, first will be amazing, but no. If I get a podium, it's a perfect result for me. at the same time this year I'm in the Portuguese Championship, so I need to think about the points for the championship. So I will try to go fast, think in both championship and of course in the overall classification.
I remember a couple of years ago when you won something like car number 23, you were an outsider, even though you'd won it a couple of times. You came to the end of the Tranquilla stage and realized that you'd won, tears everywhere. What was that feeling like?
Yes, because at this time I was not making rallies so often, just one, two per year. So as you can understand, at this level it's difficult to fight for the victory. And this year, fortunately, I have a full program in Portuguese Championship. And of course, if I have the opportunity to make more events in the IRC, I would like to make that, because I love the championship, as you know. So we'll see the future. Of course, if I win again, maybe you can see another time some tears.
That's it. Great. Thank you very much, Bruno. And enjoy yourself this weekend. We'll be catching up with you during the stages. Okay, so we've seen most of our drivers. The last team that we're going to see this evening is the Stock Sport team. And we've got in the white car. I love white rally cars. Chris gets a bit worried about me because I keep going on about white rally cars. In my opinion, it should be the rule that all rally cars are white. I love them. But Chris Ingram, completely virgin white rally car in this car here, the number three. Then next to him is his teammate, Alex Souloftis from Cyprus. Remember, we saw him a couple of times last year, now doing a full program. And we kind of have two extremes of colours here. Plain and simple, and then it looks like it's gone through a pot of paint, the other one. So, but no, I can't wait. And Ingram, I think he's got a chance at this championship. I really do.
Yeah. Ingram, strong driver. He's kind of, I would say, he's a bit of a veteran here on the island. He's been here for so many times, and he loves it. Let's have a quick word with Chris Ingram. Chris Ingram, I love calling you by your full name. It's Chris Ingram. Chris from the UK. Well, I was just saying to Julian, you're a bit of a veteran on this island. You've been here many times. Again, highs and lows here on the island.
Yeah.
You know, back in the R5 again this year with Toksport. How's everything going for you? Feeling confident for you? Because we've got good feelings for you for the championship for this season.
Thank you very much, Chris. Yeah, so good to be back. I absolutely love this rally, everything about it. I've won my class here 3 times, so I'm feeling very confident. I feel like we've got the perfect package now. The team are incredible. The car's proven. Ross and myself are working really well. And I've got a new engineer this year, Lewis Allen, who won the championship last year. So we've got everything apart from the budget, but hopefully a strong result here will help us carry on.
Yeah, I saw you at the test on Monday. It was great to see you. You're looking very relaxed and very confident with having the new engineer alongside with you. How does that help you? I mean, what sort of feedback does he give you, and what do you give him? And how can you make the car just perform so well on the stages here that you know so well? I mean, what's the secret? You don't have to give it all up to us, but just so we get an understanding of that.
For me, I don't get to drive much, so I'm not, you know, I've got a lot to learn still on the technical side of things. So to have someone like Lewis, who's an absolute expert, even though he's so young, to sit in with me on the test sometimes as well and give me that confidence. You know, we made some changes on the test which absolutely transformed my driving. So yeah, it's just the more experience we can get, the better. And to have someone like him is good for me because he knows how to work with not just experienced guys like Tanak and looking up, but me as well. So it's all good.
And over at TalkSport, you've got Alexandros Souloftis, who is, of course, a veteran Cypriot driver. We've seen him in Cyprus before. He hasn't been on the island before. This is the first time for him here. Are you two guys talking, or even though you're in the same camp, are you a bit sort of like, you know, you on one side and him on the other?
No, definitely not. I mean, I only met him this week for the first time, but he's a really nice lad, and he's very confident, so he's not been asking me for any advice. So I think he's gonna be quick anyway, and it'll be good to have another teammate. It's always good to have a quick teammate that pushes you as well.
Against Alexis this weekend, he's the reigning or defending ERC champion from last year. Do you think you've got what it takes to beat Lukanuk in the Azores this weekend? I hate putting pressure on you, and I always feel guilty that I do put too much pressure on you, Chris, but do you think you can do it this weekend? Do you think you can win here?
I do, yeah. I just need to keep calm and focus. Like, I've got a lot of stress on personally at the moment, because at the moment this is my last rally, because I've just not got any money. But I believe I've got what it takes. And last year, first time in an R5 car, here we were quicker than him on a few stages. On the Volcano stage we were, so we need a clean rally and we need to keep improving.
That's good. Fighting talk, Chris Ingram. We're all rooting for you. It was great to see you here on top step of the podium winning this weekend. But I hate ramping up the pressure on you. So
I put so much pressure on myself that it's fine.
Just chill and relax. The car looks great. Julian was just saying that the car looks great in white. It does look pretty nice, factory fresh.
Definitely, yeah. It's a bit different. And I've not even got a new suit yet because we're waiting for a title sponsor to come on board. So hopefully that'll be Gran Canaria. But for this, we need to do our best in this white beast.
And Andrew's heat for hire is still backing you a little bit there.
Hopefully. I'll find out tomorrow, actually.
Right, okay. Chris Ingram, thanks very much. Right, where's Alex? Where's he gone? Is he run off?
Alex hasn't arrived yet. That's why you did an extended interview.
Thanks, Chris. I think you can come back for an extended interview if you want.
You can come back pretty quick. You've got a lot to talk about, has he?
No, we're just waiting for a teammate to turn up.
I know. We've had a look in his car. We've had a bit of a look. I tell you what, why don't we? Come this way. Take that camera and get him to give a bit of a guided tour. Because that's got a wide angle.
Come on, Chris Ingram. No pressure,
pressure now.
No,
going to give us a guided tour of the car.
Door open, obviously. This is go on, you do it.
So this is the same car I used last year on Rally GB that was actually underwater, but it's been fully rebuilt and it's looks brand new, doesn't it? So we've got the latest engine in, brand new everything pretty much. Talksport have given me an amazing opportunity to try and win, and that's the lens you need to get to the top. You need the best kit possible.
With this guy, I remember talking to you in the Azores last year when you moved up from the Opel the previous year, from the Opel, which was kind of like a glove, and then you moved up to this. I remember you saying to us at the end of the stage that it's so scary. You just don't understand how quick the scenery is going past you outside the window, because you're still driving, but yet the green stuff's going a lot faster. Yeah. You got used to that now then?
Definitely. It's actually so much easier to drive than a two-wheel drive car. It's just like it's literally like a PlayStation. The problem is, you've got to remember it's 200 grand if you crash. So that, that's the only problem. The rest of it, it's such a drivable car, and pretty much anyone could jump in one and drive it fairly quick. But to get the last couple of percent, that's where the challenge is. But I think we're getting there. Last year we set a few fastest times, and at the end of the year, some really strong results and podiums overall. So if we can have a full year, I'm really confident we can be at the top.
That's good. This car, I suppose, as you say, is like driving a PlayStation, but you can't press reset when you go off into the weeds. But tell us, can you jump in? Let's have a quick look in here, because this is normally how we talk to you at the end of the stages, Chris. Obviously, we're just having a bit of a chat to you, because it's nice to see you. But let's just go through. Let's get Raf in here. Maybe let's have a quick with Raf as he just slides in. So tell us about the buttons. I mean, don't give us away too many secrets, but how do you start this thing?
I can't tell you that, you'll nick it.
I'm not from Manchester like you.
So there's the main switch, ignition switch, starter button, and then, with 10 seconds to go on the start line, first gear, engage first, clutch down, then with 5 seconds to go, the launch control, full throttle, and that's when the car optimizes we set it to what the perfect rev limiter will be for whatever the services of the start, and then drop the clutch and we're away. And I think 0 to 60 in these is just over 3 seconds, so it's a bit of a beast.
So do you find yourself that you've kind of, by the time you've gone through that start up procedure and hitting launch control and firing into the stage, I know that you're fully focused as you go into that stage, but do you kind of wake up a few hundred meters into the stage and then realize that you're actually off the line and you're right?
Yeah, the first time I get back in it, I actually feel sick the first start, because it's just unbelievable. You can't take it. It's even worse than the passenger seat whenever you're riding one. But the funny thing is, the first stage of this rally last year, my first rally in R5, I stalled on the start line because I've never done launch control. So hopefully that won't happen this time.
We saw these cars in the hotel, because you're staying in the same hotel as us here in Ponte Delgado, and the cars were actually parked after the pre-event test on Monday in the car park in the hotel. Yeah. And Julian and I came back from our day out, and we're like, that's Chris Ingram's car, that's parked up there. And we wanted to pull the door to see it, because it doesn't have any locks on the outside. Can you lock it?
I'm not sure.
I didn't want to, I thought the alarm would have gone off if I pulled the door handle.
To be honest, I don't know much about this car. I just get in and drive it.
So you got the buttons in the middle, in the centre console there. Yeah. So you got fans, you know, blower, light pods, all that kind of stuff.
Interesting thing is there's five different settings for the what would be the turbo. So, you know, five is full aggressive, full anti-lag, and then on this we're using three because it's so tight and twisty. That's something a bit technical for you.
Okay, thanks very much, Chris Ingram. Good luck this weekend. Thanks very much for talking to us. I think your colleague or your teammate has arrived on the other side. He's somewhere over there. We'll just hop out. Thanks very much, Chris.
Cheers, Chris.
There you go. Thanks for filling some time for us. I'll see you. Very much, Chris Ingram. That's Chris Ingram. I'm not sure which camera we're with at the moment. With Chris, who's on the other side, and
with me.
Of course,
right.
Julian.
We're going to go back over to our chairs now. We've shut that door, so we'll go back over to our chairs, and we're going to get ourselves. I do like this. I have to say, I'm going to go in this one. It's not great from a cameraman for Chris, but we have several other cameramen. But our other Chris is going to come across. But we've got Fred, we've got Chris, we've got little Chris, we've got big Chris, we've got Fred, we've got Raf. Grace taking the photographs here. But just bring it in a little bit there, Chris. Let's see where we're going to go during the season. Because we're about at the end of our time. If I look at my watch, we are about at the end of our time.
How quickly everything goes by so quickly.
We were thinking, how are we going to fill an hour? I don't know how many people have stayed watching because they probably got sick of us, but what I've discovered is how relaxed these drivers are when you think tomorrow morning they've got free practice, qualifying, a real hectic schedule in between, and then the first three stages tomorrow night. They're so calm and relaxed.
I think the opening round of the season in the Azores is it's pretty special because a lot of the rallies on the ERC are quite compact. You know, we have the qualifying stage on, let's say, Friday, and we rally Saturday, Sunday, or indeed qualifying on Thursday, and then Friday, Saturday rally, just 2 days. The Azores is extended. It's a long event in terms of we've got the street city stage tonight in the centre of Ponte Delgado, and then, you know, qualifying in the morning, as you say, three stages, and then the rest goes on to Saturday evening. So it's a real big event, and it's quite drawn out, which is great because everyone's made such an effort to come out here. We haven't mentioned, you can't really see, but behind all these shops here and where the service park is, we've got the ERC ferry, which is tied up on the other side.
It's next to my yacht. That's where that is.
The ERC ferry, which is everything, the whole championship fits on the ferry and has sailed out from Lisbon here. But 3 days of action before.
Well, that's it. Let's talk about those 3 days, as we said. Tomorrow, three stages in the evening. First stage we haven't used for many years. Then we go like into another stage we have used. Then we go to the super special that we all love, and it just gets more and bigger every year because they just big it out of the quarry. Friday, big day of stages, but it's all about Sete Sedadis on Friday, the volcano stage. We drove it yesterday. I've got a feeling, no disrespect, Chris, I don't think your stage time will challenge anybody from yesterday.
No, because we did keep stopping to look at the view because it was so beautiful. We did did drive around the volcano stage yesterday to have a quick look at it. But, you know, it's just an incredible rally. And what a great way to start the season, Julian, here in the Azores. Then we're on to Canaries, on to Tarmac for the season, Rally Liepaja, and the list goes on.
All the way down. I mean, and we finish on the famous Tronchina stage, which has caught people out last year. Martin Kocsi went out in that final stage. So the whole rally is demanding. It's a big, big ask. It's so narrow, so changeable, the grip and everything. I can't wait. I just cannot wait to see. But as you said, eight rounds. We're at number one. When we get to November, we're down here. I have no idea what's going to happen.
We'll find out. Join us on ERC Radio tomorrow morning when we're live on the qualifying stage. And join us throughout the season, of course, at every stage. And Julian and myself. But let's just have a look ahead at the season coming up here on the ERC. Thanks for watching. We'll see you later on.